Good afternoon, good morning, whatever time you're watching this. Welcome to YouTube Church. This is Matt. The subject I'm going to be talking about today, if you really let this sink in, can absolutely change your life so much and your perspective on the Bible, on God, on the gospel, that it'll be one of the best 5 minutes of your life if you really understand it and let it sink in. And that is this notion of finding rest in the finished work of Jesus Christ. You know, I talk to so many people, and I think they look at salvation and the way to heaven and the way to get right with God almost as a rope to heaven that they must constantly each day wake up and work so hard and climb towards. Often you even hear people, I've seen it in the Catholic Church, that shows a big scale that your good has to outweigh your bad, and you're constantly dealing with this inner turmoil. Is my good outweigh my bad? Am I better than this person? Am I good enough? Is God seeing all the good I'm doing? And you're working so tirelessly trying to be righteous and right before God, when the true answer to salvation is finding rest in Jesus Christ. So instead of a rope, instead of a scale, we should look at it more as a chair. That the chair is this finished work that Jesus Christ did for us on that cross. And we are simply to sit down, receive this gift, and take rest in what Jesus Christ has already done for us. You know, this is something, rest is a topic that's not talked about enough these days, because we focus so much on individualism and goal setting and pursuing your dreams and chasing after and hard work, and all these things are great. But so often you see throughout the Bible, it talks about finding rest in God. One of the verses I quote often is, "My yoke is easy, my burden's light." Jesus never, ever intended for us to just work our way to heaven or think we always have to be on the go and doing something to please him all the time. I think of it in it, just an example with my children. What if my children's name are Blake and Brody? I think, what if Blake and Brody thought every day when they woke up, I hope I do enough good things for my dad to love me, to accept me, to want me? And any of you that's a parent, you know how far from the truth this is. That they don't have to do anything. In matter of fact, they can do whatever, and there's nothing that can change my love for my two sons. I love them absolutely unconditionally. I cannot love them more, cannot love them less. It's just unconditional. There's nothing they can do. I don't care if they went out and killed somebody, if they robbed a bank, dropped out of school, whatever it is. There's nothing that can change that love I have for them. Do you think if we in the sin nature know how to do that, that God that much more loves his children? He loved us so much that he sent Jesus on that cross for you and I. And I want to challenge you today to find rest today. Maybe you want to write that around on your hand, or put a little wristband on, or something on top of a note card in a refrigerator, your mirror, or whatever. Just says rest. Because so many of you, I promise you, because I'm this way, you would get more done if you learned to just rest in Christ and his grace and his goodness. You know, David says, one of the verses, another passage, Psalms 23, that I'm teaching my son, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake." Another Psalm verse says, "Be still and know that I'm God." And I challenge you to find Google even. Go on your phone or your laptop or iPad or whatever it is there, and Google Bible verses about rest. And look at that today. Maybe memorize one or two. Because when we find rest in Jesus Christ, that's what pleases him, makes him smile. You say, "God, I can't, but you can. When I'm weak, you're strong. The abundant life comes from you. You are the vine. You're the true vine. I just need to abide in you and let you work through me, Father, because my righteousness is a filthy rags. There's nothing I can do to earn my way to heaven or earn my way in right standing with you. But I can be pleasing to God, be accepted by God, and be loved by God because of what Jesus Christ did for us on the cross." Guys, that'll make you get fired up. And many of you need to know today, you need to find rest in Jesus Christ. I have to remind myself this often. Am I trying to work so hard and check so many blocks to get right with God? Or am I taking rest in that finished work? You know, the last thing Jesus said when he took his final breath here on the cross, he said, "It is finished." Praise the Lord, guys. That's your Sunday church. Go find rest in Christ today and love others just the way Christ has loved you. God bless you.